हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल इंडस्ट्रियल गुरुजी। होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेल। सो इन द सीरीज ऑफ बेसिक्स ऑफ वेल्डिंग, द टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू कवर टुडे इज वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ वेल्डिंग जॉइंट्स एंड जॉइंट प्रिपरेशंस अकॉर्डिंग टू ISO 9692। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। नाउ द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस इन एवरीवन्स माइंड, व्हाट आर द वेल्डिंग जॉइंट्स, जॉइंट प्रिपरेशंस एंड व्हाट इज देयर इंपॉर्टेंस इन वेल्डिंग। फ्रेंड्स, जॉइंट प्रिपरेशन इज अ टेक्निकल टर्म used in welding industry to describe how you prepare metal for welding. See, when you weld something, you are usually welding two pieces of metal together to form a joint. You will get good fusion only when the base metal sidewall melts and fuses with the molten metal. Joint preparation plays important role in base metal fusion. So, we will start with the welding joints. Now, what is the joint? According to AWSB 3.0, joint is the junction of members or the edges of members that are to be joined or have been joined. Whereas BS 499 says, a joint is a configuration of members. Now, we will see various types of joints. This is edge joint. In this type, two members to join are placed along the edges as shown here. Here, the joint comes under this category if the angle between the joints is 0 to 30 degree. Here I have shown a corner joint. If joint is set like this with the corners open, then it is called as open corner joint. And if the corners are closed, then it is called as closed corner joint. Here the angle between two members is 30 degree to 135 degree. The third joint category is lap joint. Here angle between members is permissible up to 5 degree. Now here I have shown the famous T joint. As name suggests, two members are set up in a shape similar to English letter T. Here, if the angle between two members is 5 to 90 degree, then it comes under T joint category. The next one is cruciform. It is similar to cross. And the last one is butt joint, which is largely used over all industries. Here, the angle permissible is 135 degree to 180 degree. But in most cases, angle between two members set is 180 degree. This is all about types of joints. Now we will see types of weld. Once you set two members to join into a particular joint category, next step is welding. Based on this, welds are divided into following types. Welding on butt joint is called as butt weld. Similarly for T joint, it is called as fillet weld. If two members are joined by a spot like shown here, then it is called as spot weld. Spot weld is also called as seam weld. When edge joint is set and welding is done along the edges, it is called as edge weld. If a hole is made in one member and it is joined to another member by filling that hole with welding as shown here, then it is called as plug weld. Plug weld is also called as slot weld. Now, if combination of fillet and butt weld is used, then it is called as compound weld. Like in here, this part is first welded with single bevel and after that, this member is welded with fillet weld. So it is a compound weld. So friends, this is all about welding joints. Now we will move towards joint preparations. In this, we will first see preparations for butt joint. The first one is square edge. As there are chances of lack of fusion for higher thicknesses, due to this straight edge, it is normally made on thinner materials of thicknesses up to 3 mm. If the edges are closed with no gap in between, then it is called as square edge closed butt preparation. And if there is gap between two members, then it is called as square edge open butt preparation. Next type of preparation is single sided butt preparation. Guys, remember, if the access from one side is restricted, in that case these preparations are used. These are made on the thicknesses between 3 to 20 mm. The type of single side butt preparations include single bevel, single V, single J and single U preparation. Friends, the name given to these types is according to their shape. If bevel preparation is made with the shape like this, only on single plate with square edge on second plate, then this type of preparation is called as single bevel preparation. Now if the bevel preparation is made on both plates making V shape, then it is called as single V preparation. if the J-shape like preparation is made on a single plate with square edge on second plate, then this type of preparation is called as single J preparation. Similarly, if the J preparation is made on both plates making U shape, then it is called as single U preparation. Friends, we have seen single sided preparations, but if the thickness of plate is more, then an access from both sides is also available, then double sided preparations are used. If the wall thickness is up to 20 to 32 mm, then symmetric double sided preparations are used. Symmetric preparations means dimension of edge preparation on both sides are same like shown here. If bevel preparation is done on both sides with other plate square edged, then it is called as double bevel preparation. Now if the bevel preparation is made on both plates on both sides making shape like V, then it is called as double V preparation. If the J shape like preparation is made on both sides with square edge on other plate, then it is called as double J preparation. And similarly, if J preparation is made on both plates on both sides making shape like U, then it is called as double U preparation. Now if the thickness rises above 32 mm, then there will be a problem of distortion. So to avoid this problem, asymmetric double sided butt preparations are preferred. Like in here shown, asymmetric double V preparation with 2/3 and 1/3 preparation. First, welding from 2/3 side is done to half of depth, then back gouge the root, and welding from 1/3 side is completed, and in the last remaining half of weld from 2/3 side is completed. These measures are taken to avoid distortion. Till now we have seen joint types and edge preparation types. Now we will see terminology behind it. Let's see terminology for single V butt joint. The angle for single plate joint preparation is called as bevel angle, and the angle made with both plates is called as included angle. This included angle plays major role in manipulation of electrode for complete fusion. The bevel angle set for single V butt joint is 25 to 30 degree, whereas included angle is 50 to 60 degree. The straight portion at the bottom of the plate is called as root face. This root face is essential to avoid burn through during welding. Now the gap kept between two plates is called as root gap. Terminology will remain same for single J and single U joint preparation. Here two additional terms get introduced. One is root radius and other is land. Bevel angle set here is 8 to 12 degree and included angle will be 16 to 24 degree. Remember guys, included angle is always double of bevel angle. Here typical dimensions for V joint are shown. Standard dimensions for V joint are bevel angle 30 to 35 degree, root face should be 1.5 to 2.5 mm and root gap should be 2 to 4 mm. So far we have seen joint types, weld types and terminology. Now we will overlook upon factors which affect joint preparation. The first one is thickness. So far we have seen thickness limits for all types of joint preparations. In practice, they are used as same. Next is material. Many times bevel angle and other things like root face depends on material type. For example, for steel, standard bevel angle set is 30 degree, but in case of aluminium, it is set up to 45 degrees to avoid lack of sidewall fusion problem. Next is joint access and extent of penetration required, as in case of single and double sided joints. Welding distortion control is also considered, as in case of symmetric and asymmetric joints. There is one major factor which impacts on selection of joint preparation is cost. For example, cost for single J and single U preparation is more than single bevel and single V preparation, as it is done by machining. So one has to take into consideration these factors while selecting joint preparation type. Here applicable weld combinations for T joint are shown. First is fillet welded T joint. Second is butt welded T joint. Here single bevel joint preparation is used in T joint. And the third one is compound welded T joint. Here combination of butt and fillet weld is used. Now the applicable weld combinations for lap joints are First is fillet welded lap joint. Here fillet weld is used in the lap joint. Second is spot welded lap joint. And third is compound welded lap joint, as fillet and spot both welds are used. Similarly, applicable weld combinations for closed corner joints: fillet welded closed corner joint, second is butt welded closed corner joint, and third is compound welded closed corner joints, as both butt and fillet welds are used. Now let's discuss importance of terms bevel angle, root face and root gap. First we will see bevel angle. Bevel angle must allow good access to root for proper fusion, manipulation of electrode to ensure sidewall fusion, and precise value to reduce weld volume, thereby distortion and weld cost. Now the root gap and root face sizes are said to allow controlled root fusion and reduce the risk of burn through. It is too large, then there are chances of lack of root penetration. Larger root face for higher heat input processes. This will reduce weld volume, thereby distortion and weld cost. Friends, this is all about weld joint preparations. Hope all of you have understood. These are very simple to understand and most commonly used in welding industry. The joint types which I have explained are given in ISO 9692, that is welding and allied processes, recommendations for joint preparations. So friends, if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit bell icon for updates. Please comment below on what topic you want my next video. Thank you.